Hello, Bumtase. Do welcome back to the chat with Dolphin. Please do subscribe if you haven't, but if you did, of course, thank you so much for subscribing. And yeah, man, let's get to it. Apparently, Prophet Zuke is back, and she finally responded after trending for a long time because of what she had said about the late Uzanele Mbokazi, you know, long time ago. And now, because everyone has been waiting for her response, or rather say her apology for what she had said about Uzanele Mbokazi before her passing, guys, she has finally came and explained, and she's not even taking her words back. She's striving. She's still standing on business and exposing the Zulu tribe. And guys, let's just get into this video, and I will give you my commentary afterwards.
Hello everyone, I hope you're well. My name is Zugiswa. I am a prophet before God, a servant of the Lord Jesus Christ, born again, baptized and Holy Spirit filled, commissioned in 2023 to be a prophet and a prophetic voice to the black and brown people in the world. I hope you're well. Today I'm making this video about the second one, about Uzanele Mbokazi. And the Lord again came back to me about Uzanele Mbokazi. He says, the table of a harlot, Uzanele Mbokazi. And for all those of you, I've seen some of your videos where you say, I speak about her because she's already died. No. I spoke about her when she was still alive. And the Lord has been speaking to her for a long time. And I must send a very serious warning that we are at the end times. That means the times of we have entered in, they are written death all over it. Death all over it. The angel of death is in the earth, harvesting souls in numbers. The Lord says that you will bury your loved ones one after the other until you have no heart and no tears in your heart to cry for them if you continue in sin. The theme of this whole season is Ezekiel 34 basically says, a soul that sin will die. And for all those of you Zulu people, I'm going to say it for the umpteenth time, KZN is under judgment for Shembe worship, witchcraft, trafficking with the fallen. There's even surnames that the Lord said will not continue to live in the earth. Surnames like Kwanazis. The Lord has a very harsh judgment for the KZN. And Uzoma is the part of that judgment. Because you guys are idolaters in the heart. You will worship anything else but God. That thing you call a Zulu kingdom, it is not a Zulu kingdom. It is just not even a tribe. It is a clan. Zulu people were once the prophets before God, were the prophets of God that God took from Egypt right down to South Africa. And the nature is going to start fighting against y'all because y'all don't listen. I've been standing here for a year talking about you and that Shembe church and that fallen angels you are following and what it means to the nature when you keep going that way, when you keep going that way, but you continue. God says one, you guys say 100. God says 150, you guys say 1,000 because you are in sin. Just like Pharaoh, the Lord will do it again. So our banner scripture for today is Romans 1, verse 28 to 32. Let's read. Even as they did not like to retain God in their knowledge, God gave them to a debased mind to do those things which are not fitting, being filled with all unrighteousness, sexual immorality, wickedness, covetousness, maliciousness, full of envy, murder, strife, deceit, evil-mindedness. They are whisperers, backbiters, haters of God, violent, proud, boasters, inventors of evil things, disobedient to parents, undiscerning, untrustworthy, unloving, unforgiving, unmerciful. Who, knowing the righteous judgment of God, that those who practice such things are deserving of death, not only do the same, but also approve of those who practice them. The Lord is saying, when you approve of the sin, you participate in the sin. You are an accessory to crime, therefore deserving of the judgment that is given to that sinner. So all those of you got judged, Zanelimbogas, and harshly so, and deservingly so, because he's God, he knows what he's doing. But you guys who don't even know what Zanele did in private, you are out here crying for his little, for her little 1 hour, 2 hours that she was walking behind, in front of you. Yet she was in the eye of the Lord for 24 hours a day. Instead of you coming down and say, maybe let's go to hear from God, because most of you don't pray at home, because you know God is going to scold you. You don't run a risk of God telling you off. In a private space, you are out there acting like you are prayerful in public, but at home, you don't pray. You've never spoken to the Lord all your life. All you do is get up, dress, and go on your day. You've never spoken to the Lord. You've never prayed unless you needed a house, unless you needed money. And you're killing, stealing, and destroying. That's what you call a blessing. The Lord is going to equalize a whole lot of valleys and mountains in this season. So, let's read what the Lord says. To all the people who were crying for Jezebel, the Lord calls Zanele a harlot and a Jezebel, and wants to see my face, to come and repent before me or face the same fate. The Lord is saying, all of you who went to that prayer for Zanele's health to improve, for Mamu Zanele's life to improve, the Lord says, come again and repent before him. Otherwise, the judgment that came for Zanele is coming for you too. Death, the way that Mom Zanele got it, is how it's going to come to you too, if you continue without repentance. The Lord says, I should read you all Zanele's sins before him. Harlotry. And harlotry comes fornication, adulterers, incest, any kind of sexual immorality falls under harlotry. Being married to somebody else, and to God, you can only marry once. He means it. There's no remarrying. There's no, are you divorcing? You can divorce somebody, but you will not remarry someone until that somebody is dead. Even then, if you're in the counsel of the Lord, the Lord will counsel you against it. But it is up to you. Blasphemy. This means that this is one of the sins that are not forgiven. Blasphemy. Ukuhlambalaza uNkulunkulu. Using the name of the Lord to suit your greedy desires. And then marrying and putting mud on the character of God. Everything that Zanele did stemmed from the person that did all these things to God. Calling the name of God in vain. I keep telling you, Zulus, stop this Jehovah nonsense. It is a sin before God. Exodus 20 is there, and it says, you shall not call the name of your Lord, your God, in vain. Because the Lord does not hold them guiltless who do so. This is why we were never given the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, above all name. Because the Lord refuses us to call his serious name, his ID name. Because you all don't know what realms you are spiritually dead. It is like calling an ambulance when you are not sick. You deserve to go to jail. It'll get you killed. Trampling my Sabbath. I keep saying, for all of those of you who are saying Sabbath is in the Old Testament, no, Sabbath is in Genesis 1. Men were created on the sixth day. On the seventh day, men rested with God. That is the Sabbath. And God wants that Sabbath. If you don't do, the Lord will make the land rest on top of you. Wickedness. that means you are dabbling with some form of cruelty and any form of diabolical, you are trafficking with the demons. Lastly, false church and false doctrine. The Lord calls that church that Umamu Nkambule and her husband were running, he called it a motel of spirit. Spiritual motel, the Lord called it. All those who sympathize with sinners are in covenant with that sin and therefore worthy to be judged the same. The Lord says he wants all of you to call each other and go there where you prayed for Zanele Mbogazi. But this time, call it repentance. For you made a public spect of disrespect to God. Therefore, repentance must be public too. The Lord says you will not be able to be allowed to drag his name in public and pray for the people he has judged and then repent in private. He wants that repentance all over TV, all over social media, the same way you did for Uzanele, or the same judgment.
You know, by looking at things now, guys, the way things are on the internet surface, I've seen many videos from the Zulu people coming for O Prophet Suki, and I honestly don't know how it's going to turn out, but I'm not a prophet, although I think they are gonna ban him, and like they will end up banning this woman because now they are still grieving and she comes to the social media and still make things worse for her and for Zanele Mbogazi's family. This is what she quoted. For those who do not know, Sizula will try to summarize what she is saying. Basically, she's talking about the Zulu tribe, right? People from KZN who worship Oshembe and who worship, you know, Zuma, and who treat Zuma as their God and Savior, right? And what she is trying to say is that, guys, those who worship Zuma and those who worship Oshembe as their Savior and God, they are going to die. Apparently, God is killing almost everyone who believes in Shembe and Jacob Zuma. Actually, God is punishing everyone from KZN. That's why Uzanele passed on. Apparently, it was punishment from God, because God was warning her while she was still alive, and she didn't listen. She didn't bother to repent and found herself, you know, again. But unfortunately, Bantase, as much as I always stand with what Prophet Suge is saying, I have a problem with timing. Like I said on the beginning, I remember I posted a video where I was educating people about taking prophecy series, you know, learning to understand where the prophet is coming from. Because at the end of the day, we do not know if the prophet is the chosen one or a fake one. Only God knows that, right? So now she's coming again and she's saying lot deeper things about Uzanele Mbogazi after her passing. According to me, I feel like it's still insensitive and it's still early for her to say that, according to me, mainly because people came for me and told me that, Dolphin, we do not argue with what you are saying, but please respect the date because it's still early for you to come and say this and this and this and this about the late. So I'm just going to give her the same advice. As much as I do trust her as a prophet and whatsoever, I honestly feel like this is too insensitive, especially for the family, because it's, you know, people are worshipping, people are now grieving for the deceased. And now when they come across this video, it's going to make them angry. Zulu Nation are going to come for her, and we don't know if she's going to be saved or, you know, she's going to lose her life. Because at this point, now the people are making their own petition against O Prophet Suki. She's trending all over social media. People want to cancel O Prophet Suki, especially after the revelations that she made about OCC Zanele Mbogazi. Guys, it's just too early for me. I honestly feel like at least in Kaba Island, Udra Lonyana, just for now, at least this dust, you know, and come back later on. But unfortunately, Ocean Jalo. And yeah, I mean, tell me what you think, Vanda. Say, have a lovely day. I love you.